In 2015, the Indian Prime Minister and the French President agreed that you will have 36 fully loaded aircrafts being given to India, no manufacture in India, and these will be on terms cheaper than the 2007 terms. Better terms than 2007. Now, what were those better terms? And I am asking this basic question. You can take the simple aircraft and you can take the fully loaded aircraft. The 2007 offer had both. What was negotiated from 2015 to 2016 and finally executed in 2016 with the escalations and the currency violations and the variations, the basic aircraft price turns out to be 9% cheaper. Is the Congress party aware of this? Let's come to the pricing issue.
Right.
I am going to tell you something very limited because I am raising some questions. Let them answer it.
You want the Congress to answer it.
The Congress and its leader, Mr. Rahul Gandhi, to answer. Every fact that they have said on pricing is factually false. And I repeat, every fact is false, not one fact is true. Mr. Rahul Gandhi himself has given some 7 different prices in different speeches with regard to the Rafale. That is the 2007 offer. And the simple case is, as though this is a kindergarten debate or a primary school debate. Well, I was paying 500 and something, you've paid 600, 1600 and something. That's the argument being given. It shows how little an understanding he has. I have at least twice repeated this sentence. How much does he know and when will he know? Can you compare a basic aircraft, its pricing with a loaded aircraft? Can you compare a simple aircraft with a weaponized aircraft?
The Congress party is set to make Rafale into an election issue. It's already begun that in the next 8 months. What is your party's strategy?
The falsehood of Mr. Rahul Gandhi making truth into a victim and compromising national security will well be a national issue. And that's the effort I'm currently engaged in.
To say you're a liar and you're a liar and that's
no,
it?
I measure my words, and therefore there are better ways of saying the same thing.
And are you going to be mounting a campaign, your party, to counter this? Or is it just going to be ignoring what
Certainly, our party is always active. In fact, we are always hyperactive. And therefore, once this truth comes out, these are my questions. Let them answer it. If they don't answer it, or if they try an issue deflection, then I'll give my next response.
You're expecting an answer from Mr. Rahul Gandhi or Mr. Antony?
Well, I want the appropriately the Congress party and its president must answer.
Right.
If Mr. Antony remembers the facts, he would have told them what my escalation clauses were, what my currency fluctuation impact was. He would have at least told them. Both Mr. Antony and Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh would have known that there was a secrecy clause that they signed. Mr. Antony signed it. He would have at least told Mr. Gandhi before he made a speech in Parliament, don't say this, there is a secrecy clause which I have signed.
Do you think that they are deliberately not telling Mr. Gandhi? Is that your sense?
Well, that's a presumption I'll leave to you and to your viewers.